Today we're going to learn how to install the TMC2208 by Bigtree Tech for Steppers on the MKS SGen L version 1.0. Now I need to point out a couple of things. So I'm going to point out that we have our X stepper over here, our Y stepper, our Z stepper, our E0 stepper, and our E1 stepper. And as you can see, there's lots of pins in here to configure, but the ones that we're concerned with are the UART, which I'll explain a little bit more in depth. And we also need to know that the enable pin is located here, 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 and here. That's a very important pin in order to align your stepper drivers correctly, but I'll point that out in a moment. So for now, what I'm going to show you how to do is actually connect the UART jumper, because we need to place a jumper to enable it. So I'm going to place it right here, and then I'm going to push it down. And that's how you connect the jumper for your X stepper. And then for your Y stepper, you're going to do the same, and then you're going to push it down. Okay, this is the underside of the TMC2208. And as you can see, there is a red row of pins on the top part of the screen. That's going to match up to the green side on your MKS SGen L stepper port. And the black side obviously will line up with the black side. But at the very top, where it says J2, there is a tiny resistor pad. And there's a resistor located right here at the end of the hook on this that you can see right here. If that's missing, you may have issues with stepping. And this only applies to the Bigtree Tech that makes the TMC2208. A lot of people have seen it, so I just wanted to make you aware of it. Here is the top side of the Bigtree Tech TMC2208, and it's the version 3.0. Now I need to point out a couple of things. We have a trim pot over here that we're probably never going to use, but I wanted to make sure you're aware of it. We have our enable pin that's located down here, and then we have our ground pin and our direction pin right here. These are important for lining up how you're going to insert your stepper. We also have a what looks like a gold or copper plane here, and that's going to be used for wicking away heat to our heat fins that we'll place on top when printing. Now I also need to point out that these steppers can run hot. You're going to have to run a fan, keep them cool. And I'll show you in later tutorials how to hook that up, but for this tutorial I'm going to leave it out. So I wanted to show you the manual for the MKS SGen L version 1.0, and I wanted to show you the UART setup mode. Now UART stands for Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter. That's another way of saying that it's asynchronous communication via serial. So that's how it communicates with the stepper. So I'm going to go back over here, and we're going to look up how to connect the UART. So as you can see, those pins that I spoke about for UART are located down here. Those are where we're going to place our jumpers. And then I'll explain how to actually set up the stepper driver and verify that it's good. So to install the stepper, we need to locate the enable pin, but in this case, because it has a red row, we already know how it's going to be oriented because the black row will match to the black row on the actual stepper. We're going to place it here, knowing that the enable pin is located right here, and then apply a little bit of pressure to put that in place. Now we're going to do the same for the other stepper, and we're going to place this down as well. Now, I would normally place cooling fins on top, but because this is just an example and I'm not going to be running these heavily, I'm not going to do that for this example. But I need to remind you, and I might remind you several times, that in order to use these steppers, you may need to have a cooling fan on it so that they don't overheat. And also, no one is paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So to set this up to load, what we need to do is attach the big side of the USB serial cable to the board right here. And then we need to attach the small side to the computer, and you may hear a beep. So now that the MKS S-Gen L is connected, we get a removable drive that becomes visible. This is because we have an SD card inserted in our drive. And as you can see, it says firmware.cur in capital letters. That means that was a recently loaded firmware. So it's been capitalized. I'll show you what happens in just a moment with what it looks like before we load it. So I'm going to go over to VS Code. And I've already downloaded and extracted the Marlin 2.0 firmware. So I'm going to go to my file explorer over here. I'm going to click on open folder. And I'm going to go to the Marlin unzip folder. And there's one below it that we need to go to. Then I'm going to say select folder. Inside here, it's going to load all the parts that we need to actually build. And it will download the other parts that we need depending upon what we enable. So we're going to go over to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, and then we're going to click on boards.h. And we're going to search on MKS underscore SGen. And we have our board right here. So I'm going to highlight that. I'm going to copy it. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to minimize the core folder, the source folder, and go to configuration.h. I'm going to do a search on motherboard. And I'm going to highlight the RAMPS board that's right here at the moment and paste ours over it. Then I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to change the serial port to -1. And then I'm going to go down to the actual steppers to see what's going on. So I have to do a search on A4988. That'll bring us to the neighborhood of where we need to be. And we're going to be working with the TMC2208. So we need to enable this by removing the comments that are in front of the line for the X and the Y stepper. And for good practice, we'll do the Z stepper. And we'll also do E0 and E1. And that's only part of what we have to do to configure it. The next thing we have to do is copy the TMC2208, paste it in for the steppers that we are using, being these two for X and Y. Now, if we scroll down here, there's a little bit more to configuring. Now, in this case, it's set for the A4988 as the default stepping. But in previous tutorials, which I highly suggest you watch for steppers, being the A4988 and the DRB8825, you'll understand why I changed these numbers. But for now, I'm going to change them to 400. Just because, and that is for 1/32nd of a step on the DRB8825. But because we're doing more than that in the future, if you want to do this on the TMC2208, what you're going to need to do is if you want 1/64th of a step, you would have to change the 400 to an 800. But this is based on the example in my previous tutorial on steppers. So But for now, we're going to leave it at 1/32nd of a step. And then we're going to go over to the configuration underscore advanced dot h. And in here, we're going to search on, 800. And this may be a couple of searches. And this brings us to our steppers for Trinamic. Now, what we need to do in order to configure these are, normally the current is 800, so we're going to leave that alone. But because we're doing 1/32nd of a step, we need to change the 16 to a 32. If you were to use a greater degree of step being 1/64th, then it would be 64. But considering we're only doing 1/32nd of a step, I'm going to do 32 for both the X and the Y current. Now I'm also going to turn on debug here. So we're going to do a search on TMC debug. So I may have to scroll down for a second to find it. What this is it allows us to have debugging that we can use to actually do analysis if something happens. Now there are other functionality that I'm not talking about in this, and there's like stealth chop. This is already defined. If you want to disable it, you'd put comments in front of it and it would turn into spread cycle mode. And then there's a hybrid mode of that, which I'm not going to go into as well, but you would need to remove the comment down here to enable it. And I'll let you experiment with that on your own. But for now, what we're going to do is go back to trying to find our debug. So I'm going to do a search on debug. And I found TMC debugging. So I'm going to remove the comment for that. Next, there's another debug that I need to find in here. And let's see if I can find that. It might be nearby. It usually causes me a few moments to search for it. But I think it's down here. And what this is doing is allowing us to use the command for debugging. So unfortunately, I'm not finding it right away. So let's see if we can get away with just using this. It's TMC debug that you're interested in. Now there's another one that I may need to find. Unfortunately, going around in circles here, so I don't want to spend too much time. Here it is. It's monitor driver status. So we're going to remove the comment to enable that. These two things are required just to show you what's going on. You'll understand later on why these are important, but you normally don't need to enable this and this when everything is running fine. This is a way to actually see if there's an... So next we need to go over to platform.io.ini, and we need to find out the correct default environment that we're using, because this is set up for the Mega 2560, which is the RAMPS combination. And what it actually is for the chipset is LPC 1768. So I know that off the top of my head because I've worked with this board before. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a build. It's also known as compile. But what we're going to do in this case is we're going to use upload because we're directly connected to it via the serial port. So I'm going to click on this, and in a few moments, we'll take another look and see what has occurred. Okay, now that you can see the compile has completed successfully, or succeeded, you can double check the actual chipset, and that looks like it succeeded as well. So let's go back over to the drive for the SD card that we're connected to via USB serial. And as you can see, it says firmware.bin. That means that it's copied over. So what we're going to do now is we're actually going to disconnect the USB so that when we power it back up, it automatically loads it. So I've reinserted the USB. It's going to take a second to load the firmware, and then we should get a pop-up for a browser window, but we may not. So let's see if we can find it here. So over here, looks like it just loaded. Notice that the time has changed. So off camera, I connected the power for 12 volts. I also have everything unplugged at the moment so I can show you this. I also connected a NEMA 17 stepper for both the X and the Y. And let's see, everything is disconnected for the USB serial. So I'm going to reconnect the USB serial here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the actual power. And this will energize the system. Now keep in mind that once everything is energized, you don't want to touch the board because you don't want to damage your equipment or yourself, which would be worse. Okay, now we're going to test this in Pronter phase. I'm going to open it up. I'm going to connect to the board. As you can see right now, it says printer is online. So we're going to check to make sure the steppers are okay by doing M122, pressing enter. And as you can see, it says that both the X and the Y are okay. Now all of this has to do with, we turned on TMC debug and the monitor. We can comment this out in Marlin later on to turn it off, but this was just so we could see that it's okay. So let's try moving 10 steps with the X stepper. So it appears to move fine. So let's try the Y stepper. And that appears to be fine. Now, this might not move in the direction that you choose. Inside Marlin, there is a way to invert the direction. I didn't show you that for brevity, obviously, but I want to take a moment to thank you for taking the time to watch my tutorial, and please like and subscribe.